we shall now prove a theorem which states a finite commutative ring without zero divisors is a field, or a finite integral domain is a field. We have already proved that every field is an integral domain, but every integral domain need not be a field, but a particular type of integral domain is a field. That particular type is a finite integral domain is a field. Let D be a finite commutative ring without zero divisors having n element, because it is a finite, therefore it must have a finite number of elements. We consider this D has n elements. Let D be equal to, the elements are a1 comma a2 comma a3 so on an. Now we have to show that D is a field. In order to prove that D is a field, we have to show the following. That is, for all A belong to D, there exists one belongs to D such that 1 into A equals to A into 1 is equals to A. That is, the unit element or unity element or the multiplicative identity exists in D. The second one is, for every element A not equal to 0 belongs to D, there exists an element B belongs to D such that A into B equals to B into A equals to 1. That is, inverse exists for every non-zero element in D. So these are the two axioms we have to prove. If we prove these two axioms, that is, identity element exists with respect to multiplication, and every non-zero element has a multiplicative inverse in D, then we say that this commutative ring with zero divisors, which is finite, is a field. So let us choose a non-zero element A in D. That is, A may be any one of these elements. A may be A1 or A2 or A3 or An or any one of these n elements which is non-zero. Now consider the n products A into A1, comma A into A2, comma A into A3, so on A into An. That is, we multiply these n elements by the element A. Suppose A is A5. Then it becomes A5A1, comma A5A2, comma A5A3, so on A5AN. So these are the n products, and all these elements again belong to D because of closure axiom. That is, by closure law in D, all these are elements of D. Not only the elements of D, they are also distinct. Now we are going to show that these n products are distinct elements. For suppose that any two products are equal, that is, we are going to prove this by using contradiction. We assume that any two elements in these products are equal. That is, the product is AA1, AA2, AA3, so on, AAN. Let us consider any two products are equal. That is, for example, let us consider A into AI is equals to A into AJ, for I is not equal to J, and I and J are from 1 to N. I and J are from 1 to N. Now transposing AJ to the left hand side, we get A into AI minus A into AJ equals to 0. Take A common. We take A common, we get A into AI minus AJ equal to 0. We call it as equation number 1. Since D is without zero divisors, when you say without zero divisors, A into B equal to 0 implies either A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. Therefore, here a into a I minus aj equal to 0 implies either a equal to 0 or a I minus aj equals to 0. That is a equal to 0 or a I minus aj equal to 0. But what is a? We already taken a is a non-zero element. Therefore, this is not true. And hence, the only case is AI minus AJ equals to 0. That is, A is a non-zero element in D. And hence, we must have AI minus AJ equal to 0. That implies AI equal to AJ, contradicting I is not equal to J. I is not equal to J. But what you have proved here? We have shown that I equal to J. But in fact, I must be not equal to J. This contradiction arises because we assumed that any two products are equal. Therefore, our supposition is wrong. And hence, all these N products, namely AA1, AA2, AA3, so on, AAN, are all N distinct elements of D placed in some order. No, need not be the same order of elements of D. They may be placed in some order. For example, consider the integral domain. Here D is equals to 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. It has 5 elements with respect to addition modulo 10 and multiplication modulo 10. The multiplication table is this. Let us take A is equals to 4, which is not equals to 0. Here in D, we choose A equal to 4, which is not equals to 0. Now, what are the product? AA1, AA2, AA3, so on. Here, A into A1 is, A is 4, A1 is 0. So, 4 into 0 is 0. Then, AA2, A is 4, A2 is 2. So, 4 into 2 is 8. The next one is AA3. A is 4, A3 is 4, 4 fours are 16, that is 6 is the element. A into A4, 4 into 6, 4 into 6 is 4. A into A5, the last element, 4 into 8, 4 into 8 is 2. Thus, the elements of D are 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, but the product of the elements are 0, 8, 6, 4, 2. All these are all elements of D, but placed in some order. Is not the order of 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Here it is 0, 8, 6, 4, 2. So one of these elements must be equal to A. You can see here, we have highlighted with red color. What is AA4? Is a product. One of the products of these elements. But what is the value? 4. What is A? 4. That is one of these elements. That is AA1, AA2, AA3, so on, AAN must be equal to A. In this example, AA4 is equals to A. This shows that there exists an element, say, 1 belongs to D, such that A into 1 is equal to 1 into A equals to A. In this example, 6 belongs to D. What is 6 into 0? 0. 6 into 2? 2. 6 into 4? 4. 6 into 6? 6. 6 into 8 is 8. Therefore, A into 6 is equal to 6 into A is equal to A for all A belongs to D. Here we are taken 1. But in this example, this A is nothing but 6. We shall now show that this element 1 is the multiplicative identity of D. Let Y be any arbitrary element of D. Then from the above discussion, for some X belongs to D, we have A into X is equal to X into A is equals to Y. Now, 1 into Y is equals to 1 into what is Y? Y is equals to A into X. Now apply associative property. This can be written as 1 into A into X. What is 1 into A? Just now we have mentioned 1 into A is A. Therefore, A into X. What is A into X? Y. What is Y? Y into 1. Thus, 1 into Y is equal to Y into 1 is equal to Y for all Y belong to D. Thus, Y be any arbitrary element of D. So that 1 into Y is equal to 1, Y into 1 is equal to Y for all Y belong to D. Therefore, 1 is the unit element. That is the multiplicative identity of the ring D. Now, 1 belongs to D. Therefore, from the above discussions, one of the n products, namely AA1, AA2, AA3, so on, AAN, will be equals to 1. As we discussed in the example, but in this example, AA3 is the identity. AA3 is one of the products of AA1, AA2, AA3, AA4, AA5. So here AA3 is the product that is equals to 6, and 6 is the unit element. Thus, there exists an element, say, B belongs to D, such that A into B equals to B into A equals to 1. That is, B belongs to D, such that A into B equal to B into A equal to 1. This shows that B is the multiplicative inverse of the non-zero element A belongs to D. Thus, every non-zero element of D is invertible or inversible. Hence, D is a field. Therefore, a finite integral domain is a field. For example, we already discussed the algebraic structure R, addition modulo 10, multiplication modulo 10, where R is equal to the set containing the elements 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 is an integral domain. This is the multiplication table. Here, consider the topmost row 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, and the row headed by number 6 having element 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, exactly same as the topmost row. Therefore, 6 is the unit element. Now, for 2, what is the inverse of 2? The multiplicative inverse of 2 is, consider the row headed by 2. Where is the identity? 6 is the identity. The corresponding element is 8. Therefore, inverse of 2 is 8. What is the inverse of 4? Consider the row headed by 4. The elements are 0s, 8, 6, 4, 2. 6 is the identity, and hence the corresponding element 4 is the inverse. So, inverse of 4 is 4. What is the inverse of 6? 6 is the identity, therefore its inverse is itself. Now the number 8. For 8, where is the identity? Here is the identity. The corresponding element is 2. Therefore, the inverse of 8 is 2. Thus, every non-zero element has multiplicative inverse. And hence, this integral domain, which is finite because it has 5 elements, is a field.